Hi, I'm David Dodge. Welcome to Green Energy Futures. Derek Leahy is a former journalist who loves the land, so much so that he can't wait to get outside and continue his work as a farmhand. He's also passionate about climate change solutions that are great for the farm. That's why he started the podcast Rural Routes to Climate Solutions.
I'm Derek Leahy, and in this episode of Rural Routes to Climate Solutions, we're going to talk about geothermal energy and agriculture.
We were so taken with Derek's podcast series, we decided to co-produce this episode on geothermal energy in agriculture.
My guest today is Dr. Jonathan Banks, who's a research associate at the University of Alberta.
Well, geothermal broadly refers to the heat of the earth. So the reigning theory is that the earth forms in the distant past when a whole lot of space material slammed together. So the earth's interior is hot, and the deeper you drill down into the earth, the hotter it gets. So that's what geothermal energy is somehow using that thermal energy content, that heat of the earth, for either directly as heat or to convert the heat, if it's hot enough, into electricity.
Geothermal refers to harvesting of high temperatures, usually above 100 degrees Celsius, to generate steam, drive a turbine, and generate electricity. Geoexchange refers to using low temperatures of the earth, just below the surface, and running it through heat exchangers to generate heat, usually for buildings. There are more than 100,000 geoexchange systems in Canada. There are no geothermal projects yet. But Alberta does have a geothermal resource.
So the hottest temperatures, it's basically the further west you go, the hotter it gets, because you can drill deeper into the basin. So out by Hinton, Grand Cache, these areas, even up by Grand Prairie, you know, definitely get well above 100 degrees. We've seen some wells out by Hinton that are over 180 degrees.
Oh, wow.
Very deep wells, over 5,000 meter deep gas wells.
In fact, there's an active geothermal project underway in Hinton, Alberta. It's taking advantage of spent oil wells. But Banks says only a few oil wells may be suitable for high-temperature geothermal projects, but many wells may be suitable for mid-temperature projects.
So if you need to run a greenhouse or an agricultural drying operation, or if you have some sort of aquaponics going on and you need 35 or 40 degrees constantly, reliably, boom. Most wells in Alberta are suitable for retrofitting for those purposes.
And this could spark an agricultural revolution in Alberta, says Banks.
We identified hundreds of geothermal pools that are between 60 and 90 degrees. And that is like really an ideal temperature for running an agricultural operation.
Banks says it's about economies of scale. He says it might cost $300,000 to repurpose a 3,500 meter deep oil well.
But then you have enough heat to run a substantial greenhouse. But once you hit that size, your economics look good compared to gas.
That's a scale a co-op of farmers or a municipality could take on, says Banks. Listen to Derek Leahy's Rural Routes to Climate Solutions one-hour podcast.
Rural Routes to Climate Solutions is a central Alberta-based project empowering rural Albertans with climate solutions. Along with producing this podcast, Rural Routes runs workshops and farm field days. For more information about the project, visit the website at www.rr2cs.ca. Happy farming wherever you are in Alberta, and remember, what's good for the farm is usually good for the climate.
Learn more at greenenergyfutures.ca. For Green Energy Futures, I'm David Dodge.